IVM.
Hello and welcome to the Habit Coach Podcast, the bite-sized podcast filled with quick and easy actionable habits. Remember, great habits create that awesome life. I am Ashdin Doctor, your Habit Coach. Today's fun fact of the day has to do with global warming. Did you know the Earth has gone through many, many stages of global warming and coolings? We all remember the movie Ice Age? And many of these cycles are part of nature and the way the Earth revolves around the sun. Others were the cause of asteroids hitting the planet or giant volcanoes changing the face of Earth forever. Humans appear to be the cause of the next global warming cycle. We did this by increasing the atmospheric carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is what is called a greenhouse gas and traps heat. We aren't alone in this environmental changing behavior. One of the ice ages was actually caused by another living thing. Plants appeared on the scene, proliferated like crazy, sucking up all the carbon dioxide in the air and doing the exact opposite of what we are doing now. An ice age took over. The ice sheets that formed reflected the sun's heat back into space and compounded the cooling effect even more. I bet an ice age sounds pretty good right now as we sit in some of the hottest days ever recorded. In fact, this podcast was highly requested. Habits to deal with the heat. If you're not careful, the heat can catch you off guard. Deaths caused by the extreme heat are now becoming very common across the world. Dehydration and heat stroke. Believe me, you never ever want to experience these. Heat stroke can make you feel dizzy, confused, agitated, disoriented. You can start throwing up, feeling nauseous. But an interesting thing happens. You stop sweating and your body goes into shock. These are all horrible, horrible things. If you ever start feeling like this, immediately stop, stand in the shade, stand somewhere cool, sip water, and cool down the body as fast as possible. Check with a doctor. Do not take these signs lightly. On days like this, when the heat is too intense, there are a couple of easy things you can do to save yourself from catching a heat stroke. Number one, always carry a bottle of water with you. Add a pinch or two of pink salt. You can also add some lime or lemon juice. 2. Stay out of the sun between 11 and 2 in the afternoon. And 3. Walk in the shade or protect your neck and your head. If you're wearing a shirt, turn the collar up. And this is something that we do while trekking when the sun is too intense. There are tons of recipes you can get online for coolers and drinks you should have during the heat. I'm not going to get into those here because I want to talk about something more fundamental. Now that the easy stuff is over, let's talk about the hard stuff. As your habit coach, I want you to become friends with the heat. Yes, you heard me. I want you to become friends with the heat. We spend too much time worrying about it, stressing about it, and fighting the heat. Oh my God, look how hot it is today. And then we grumble about it. In fact, humans have the ability to deal with a wide range of temperatures. Our ability to sweat keeps us cool and regulates the temperature. Over the course of human evolution, our ability to survive in extreme climate zones has been our best survival tool. We no longer use our body to adapt to the climate around us. Instead, we use air conditioners to make sure that we are always comfortable. So our body hasn't learned to deal with heat and high temperatures. It doesn't mean that we can't relearn it. Like everything, it takes effort to learn and become comfortable with the heat. We have to learn to be comfortable being uncomfortable. And that is where resilience comes from. That is where growth comes from. This doesn't mean that we give up using the AC or we sweat out the summer. I love the AC and would be a total hypocrite for asking you to do that. Instead, I want you to learn to make peace with the heat. So your simple habit for surviving the heat wave is to enjoy the ride. So the next time you feel the heat and start grumbling, catch yourself. Stop. Allow your body to feel the heat. Is it a grimy, sweaty, wet heat? Is it a dry, burning heat? Does it feel like a sauna or a steam? Where are you feeling the heat? Take a deep breath. Have a smile on your face. Use the heat to center you in the moment by just feeling it on your body. Heat, in fact, is used to heal the body. So imagine your body healing. If it gets too much, stop. Don't fight it. don't take it to the point where you feel faint or get heat stroke symptoms. Instead, just enjoy it. Do this every time you feel like complaining about the heat, and within a few days, you will feel a change. You will go from drowning to surfing this heat wave. So start these habits and share with us your progress using the hashtag TheHabitCoach. If you like this podcast, don't forget to check out other interesting podcasts on the IVM network. You can listen to us on the IVM Podcast app or ivmpodcast.com. You can also follow us on social media. We are at IVM Podcasts on Twitter and Instagram. If you want to reach out to me, I am Ashdin Doc on Twitter and Instagram.
Every week comes a show where three people come together to tell you about stuff they like. A movie, a TV show, a book, and other stuff. Tune in every Monday on the IVM Podcast app to IVM Likes. Batman approves this message. Thank you, Batman.
Advertising is dead. Yep, you heard me right. Advertising is dead. We're all in the content business now. Let's not call it news, TV, radio, etc., etc. It's all content, and we're in the middle of this weirdly exciting phase where all the borders and lines that have been drawn over decades has been swept away by this lovely thing called the internet. We're a show where we don't dwell on just the stuff that is now, but rather the wider stuff about advertising, media, content, and the whole goddamn circus surrounding it. Tune in every Tuesday for our weekly unboxing of the mystery box we used to call advertising. I'm Varun Dugirala, co-founder and content chief at The Glitch, and this is my new podcast, Advertising is Dead.